Wokeism defeated. I'm S.E. Cupp. Welcome to Unfiltered. That's how some are framing the recall of San Francisco District Attorney Chesa Boudin on Tuesday. Check this out from the New York Post's homepage. Down and out, woke San Fran DA removed from office over soft-on-crime policies. Boudin, a progressive Democrat, is projected to be recalled in liberal San Francisco with 60% of the city vote so far in favor of his ousting. So what does this mean? Probably not much nationally, although the right is certainly going to insist this is, like the Post headline, a rebuke of wokeism. Now, color me skeptical, but I think San Francisco voters are probably still fairly aligned with a liberal agenda. It's a rebuke of progressivism, many are suggesting. I've heard that several times today on cable news. And listen, Boudin's lineage is as progressive as it gets. Boudin is the son of two members of the Weather Underground, a left-wing domestic terrorist group, according to the FBI. And when his parents were arrested when he was a baby, Boudin was adopted by controversial left-wing activist Bill Ayers. As a young man, he worked in Venezuela as a translator in the socialist administration of Hugo Chavez and has since aligned with progressive groups and policies. But couldn't Boudin's recall be simpler and less political than a rebuke of wokeism or progressivism? Yes, I see it a little differently. I think maybe this was San Francisco voters saying, do your job. Do the thing you were elected to do. In the case of Boudin, he was elected in 2019 as district attorney, a job that mainly involves deciding whether criminal charges should be brought against perpetrators and prosecuting criminal offenders. Amidst a rise in homelessness and crime in San Francisco, including burglaries, car thefts, murders, and others, Boudin made it his mission to focus on other stuff. Decarceration, ending cash bail, actively deciding not to prosecute criminals in some cases. There were some high-profile cases that invoked the ire of San Francisco voters, including that of Deshaun Lumpkin, a 17-year-old who was convicted for killing a 6-year-old. Boudin decided to try Lumpkin as a minor. The max he can be sentenced to is 8 years in prison. Or the case of Troy Ramon McAllister, one of many repeat offenders that raised eyebrows and tensions during Boudin's tenure. McAllister, who had several prior felony convictions, was released on parole from state prison in 2020. That year, he allegedly struck and killed two pedestrians while driving a stolen vehicle. He has since pleaded not guilty. Boudin's also faced criticism that he didn't prioritize prosecutions for hate crimes against Asian Americans. Couldn't it be all of this, and not wokeism, that led to Boudin's ouster? After all, it's unlikely Republicans lined up in droves to vote in the San Francisco recall election. There are hardly many in San Francisco. 85% of the county voted Democrat in the 2020 election. Boudin appears to have been ousted by many Democrats, likely progressive ones. So maybe the message to DAs and anyone else looking to keep their job is to do it. Do the job you were elected to do. That's it for me. See you next week.